Hello, friends and enemies. Today, I'm doing something I should have done a long time ago, but I'm just getting around to now, and that is opening up both of these Ring Arts Sora figures. So, many moons ago, I ordered the Kingdom Hearts 3 Ring Arts Sora. Life things happened, and my brain is stupid, so I forgot about it and didn't open it. And then version 2 rolled around, and I am a huge Kingdom Hearts nerd, so I also got version 2. I did the same with Riku, and his version 2 figure improved in nearly all aspects, though there were some parts of the version 1 figure I preferred, such as some of the accessories, so we're going to see if it's the same with Sora. Right off the bat, I can tell you that the version 2 Sora, his default head looks pretty derpy, if I'm going to be honest, which fits Sora's character, but you know. The derp factor can only go so high. So first off, let's take a look at the boxes. Pretty much the same. The logo work is a little bit different. On version 2, we have the authentication sticker on the front. On the first version, it is on the back. They brought in a little bit more of a plaid element on the version 2 package. And the backs are pretty much mostly the same, except on this one it says Square Enix really big, so you don't forget. Not suitable for children under the age of 3. If you give this to a child under the age of 3 years, they will be forced into a never-ending journey of discovery, where a dog and a duck make them smile all the time, but not in a good way. Because you want to be able to accept negative feelings. Not everything is happy and smiling all the time. In fact, that is a very unhealthy attitude to have. That dog and duck should be ashamed of themselves, and Sora should be free to feel his feelings. Wait, what were we talking about? Okay, let's just open up the toys. We'll start with the first version, because it is the first. I have a lot of things to say about Kingdom Hearts. Maybe more things to say than a normal person should have. So I just want to do a quick overview of version 1, looking at the figure and the accessories. Then we'll move on to version 2, and then we will look at them both side to side and compare them and accessories. It's been a while since I've opened a Ring Arts figure, so I don't really remember the feel of the other ones, but this one seems a little more plasticky to me, and I feel like that's a silly thing to say because obviously it is plastic, but the other figures, I think the plastic felt a little more high quality. Just here, like his pants in particular, feel cheap to me, and I can't articulate why that is. But they're sculpted well, the paint is really nice. You've even got a lot of subtle shading on the pants especially, like here on these pockets. You can see more on the hood. And Sora himself looks great. Big old blue eyes, like a lost little puppy dog. The paint on the crown necklace is really nice. The deco of the plaid lapels. A nice little pop of spot gloss on this belt. Yeah, he looks good. But will version 2 look better? We're going to find out. So when I opened up the package, this blaster accessory was already broken. This is meant to go in here, and it was just laying in the package. So that can be fixed with a little bit of super glue, but it is a little annoying that it was broken before even being taken out of the box. You can plug it in well enough, but that's going to need to be secured with super glue, and I will try to make it so it's not an obvious fix. But otherwise, the accessories are really nice. You get these blaster thingies, and you will have to forgive me. It has been quite a while since I played any of the Kingdom Hearts games, though I do still love them. So I don't remember the names of these blaster weapons. I know that it's like another form of the Keyblade, which we also get, of course. And I really prefer it when Sora comes with the more classic Keyblades, like especially the Kingdom Key. I feel like every Sora action figure should come with a Kingdom Key, but then I guess everyone would just have a bunch of Kingdom Keys laying around. And of course, I also don't remember the name of this Keyblade, but it looks like it has something to do with the Wayfinder trio. Maybe it's called the Wayfinder. I don't remember, and I'm very sorry. Fake fan. Fake Kingdom Hearts fan. So the other Keyblades in the Ring Arts line, this part would come out and you would slip the hand onto it and put it back in. I don't think that is the case here. This is one piece, I'm pretty sure. And honestly, that's fine with me. The other way was a bit of a hassle, though it was clever. This just is a better system. If you can get the hands rubbery enough, yet firm enough to wrap around it, there doesn't seem to be a problem. I would attach the hand first before you attach it to the arm. So yeah, as you can see here, we come with a plethora of hands. Some trigger finger hands for the guns, which is not something I ever thought I'd say in relation to Kingdom Hearts. This hand is a little scuffed up. Like, I don't know if that's just dirt or what. I have to reiterate that this figure has not been opened before. This is the first time. I don't know why it is dirty. You've got some open, relaxed hands and another one of those grip hands for the Keyblade. He will also come with one other head. It's a determined face portrait, and they did such a good job on these heads. The hair is immaculate, great sculpting, amazing shading, the eyes and the eyebrows especially. are really impressive. And it might be hard to tell on camera, but the eyes are shiny. They got kind of a spot gloss. So yeah, great work on the heads on these guys. Mostly. And we'll get to that in a minute. But I've opened a few of these figures, and the articulation is always basically the same. It's not bad. You do want to be gentle because these are relatively fragile. They are expensive. I blew money on these because I love Kingdom Hearts a lot. You know, a lot of toys to me are take it or leave it. This I could not leave because I love Kingdom Hearts. And I understand that it's an insane series. I understand that it makes no sense. But man, do I love it. Smooth movement on him. I am 99.9% sure that the articulation is going to be the same throughout both figures. But be careful when you move this leg because it's got a blunt end and this diaper part wants to crunch in a little bit. There we go. Okay. Yeah, I think you're going to have to be a little bit tactical with how you pose this. He's got enormous knee joints. And he's a bit stiff just because he's been in the package for so long, but then once you move him around a little bit, he opens up a bit. In theory, come on, Sora. Move your other knee. You can do it. Faithful recreation of the enormous shoes that they all wear for some reason. You've got a bit of an up and down on that, and some rock. Some back and forth. Yeah, there's a bit of a limit to what these can do, which is kind of a shame because I feel like Kingdom Hearts characters are always getting themselves into some pretty crazy poses, but it is not bad at all. So let's go ahead and open up the second package and look at him. So of course, with any art piece, and that's what I consider action figures to be for the most part, are art pieces, which may sound hoity-toity, but that's a whole different conversation. We're not getting into that right now. Anyway, my point is your opinion may vary wildly. Something that I may like may not be the favorite of someone else. So already I am not liking the version 2 Sora as much. First of all, that expression is Derp City. And like I said, Sora is derpy, but not to this level. My boy, what have they done to my boy? The neck looks a lot longer and thinner, which might be better for posing, but it looks so awkward. And we'll look at them side by side in a minute. The paint on the crown necklace isn't as perfect as it was in the version 1 Sora. Paint seems okay everywhere else. I am getting a little bit of sloppiness here and there. The shadows aren't as deep, I've noticed. And the hair on this one seems differently shaped than the other one, and I might be wrong, but we'll see in a moment. But yeah, this head is just not doing it for me. His joints are a lot looser than version 1, though, and that could be a good thing or a bad thing. So for version 2 Sora, you'll be getting two head portraits. You've got a happy, teeth-showing, big smile head, perfect Sora expression. You also get this visor headpiece from when he is in the Big Hero 6 world. And these heads don't look nearly as ridiculous as the one that comes on him, so I do actually quite like these. Another interesting difference, the version 2 Sora comes with the hands on these little pegs, which is a system that I much prefer to having them loose because not only can you keep track of them easier this way, but it keeps the holes from shrinking. He also comes with a gummy phone, so just a cute little accessory. And version 2 Sora will come with two Keyblades as opposed to one Keyblade and one transformed Keyblade. And both of these are intact. So I believe both of these use the system I mentioned before where you remove part of the Keyblade and then the character's hand slips onto the handle and then you put it back, which is good if your hands are not rubbery and you want a tight grip, though you could just make the hands a little bit more rubbery and not have to do that. This one is stuck a little bit, and I don't want to push it too hard because I don't want to break it. But yeah, two Keyblades. You get the Big Hero 6 Keyblade and Starlight, I think is the name of this one. Both very well produced. I love the texture of these nanobots or whatever they are on this Keyblade. So before we go on, I do want to mention that every Bring Arts Kingdom Hearts figure that I've looked at thus far in my illustrious toy channel career, heavy sarcasm, comes with a heart-shaped stand. And these two will be no different. They both come with their own stand. So let's look at them side by side, and I will try not to mix them up, though I don't think that is possible because they look very different. Even their body shapes look slightly different, but I don't think it's a whole different sculpt. I think it is the same, maybe? Version 2 Riku I liked a lot better than version 1 Riku, even though version 1 wasn't bad. For this one, version 2 is a step down. Just like this default face doesn't look like Sora as much. The neck is way too scrawny. The paint isn't quite as good. There's just less detail on the paint. You could argue that version 2 comes with cooler accessories, but man, version 1 is the one for me. I much prefer this one. And the hair looks more like Sora's hair. I mean, if you're a Kingdom Hearts nerd, you know that Sora's hair actually changes quite a bit from Kingdom Hearts 1 onward. But yeah, this just doesn't look correct to me. It's not terrible. Like, if you're in the market for a Sora figure and this is what you find, it's not bad at all. Especially with the alternate heads. But this one is just, in my opinion, better. This one's taller, too. They gave him leg extension surgery. Or is it just that neck? He's part giraffe. Yeah, man, I don't know. So for the Riku figure, I kept some stuff from version 1, but ultimately I'm going to be selling that one. For this one, I will be selling version 2, I think. But I will be keeping the accessories because I like those. But yeah, the joints on this one are a lot smoother. But as I said, that could be a good thing or a bad thing. Sometimes when you mess around with a figure too much, it becomes floppy. You don't want that. I am curious about something, though. I noticed that the head joints are different. So version 1 came with an extra head without a peg in it. For version 2, the heads come with pegs, and that might mean that they are not interchangeable or you have to remove the peg from his head on this one. I'm going to take a look. His head is very spiky. Yep, I'm not sure about that. I think that this peg is just in there. There's a ball joint in this neck and it does not want to come out. You could probably force it out maybe with hot water and pliers, but I don't know how willing I am to do that. For this one, the head comes off so easy. But the version 1 heads don't have pegs in them, so you are stuck with the version 2 heads. Version 2 looks a lot better with a different head, but still not as good as this one. So I'm really conflicted because they made the head swapping situation difficult for this one in a way that it wasn't with the Riku figure. So yeah, still prefer version 1, but version 2 with an alternate head is not that bad. It's just that this head, his smile is so derpy. Sorry, Sora, but it is. So there is a way to switch the heads. Unfortunately, it involves also switching out the necks. So you can take off the necks of each of these Soras and switch them around, and that's how you will transfer the heads to different bodies. Unfortunately, that really doesn't do much for my plan of keeping one body and the heads and then selling the other body with one head attached. Because I need both necks still. I really wish they had just stuck with the head system they had before. But yeah, if I'm going to recommend one of these Soras, it's got to be version 1. Version 2 just, it just isn't as good for all the reasons that we've gone over. However, if that's the only one you can get your hands on, it's still not bad if you want a highly detailed Kingdom Hearts 3 Sora. I know there are also PlayArt's Kai figures. I have never gotten any of those, so I can't speak to how they compare to these, because all I've ever gotten are Bring Arts, and they're usually really good. This one is a bit of an outlier, but as I said, it's not terrible. So for just a quick comparison, we have Bring Arts Kingdom Hearts 3 Riku, and this is version 1. So the likeness on him isn't great, but he is a Riku, and he just towers over Sora. Sora is kind of a small guy, he's still pretty young. Riku is older, but I don't remember him being that much taller than Sora in the games. He's just he's a giant compared to Sora, oh my god! But all the Bring Arts Kingdom Hearts figures look really cool together. There's still a few that I have not opened, so I'm excited to open those and get the whole crew together. I do wish that they had come out with a Vanitas figure. I think they're done with this line. I'm not sure, but I think they are. They said they're releasing one more, and then they announced Naminé, so I think she may have been the last one. But man, Vanitas would have made such a cool figure. I will be forever, forever missing out on that. So I hope this was informative in some capacity. I am a huge Kingdom Hearts nerd. You don't need to tell me how lame it is, I know. And I just love talking about it. Disappointed in the version 2 Sora, disappointed in the head swapping system we've got set up, or the non-existent head swapping situation, as it were. But for the most part, I find these Bring Arts figures delightful. Or maybe it's just that I find Kingdom Hearts delightful, I don't know. So, likes and subscribes are very much appreciated, comments are more than welcome, and I will see you guys on the next one.